Hello, my name's Kenny Durkee, and I'm an inventor, but was at one time an auto repair shop owner. And back in the day, I was just a one-horse show, and occasionally a customer would call me and say, my car's broken down, can you come and help me? And I wouldn't know what was wrong with it until I got there, so I'd go to my toolbox, I'd get a crescent wrench, a pair of pliers, screwdrivers, a hammer, just some basic tools, and off I'd go. And one day it occurred to me, what if I could just grab one tool and just go? So if I could combine everything into one. So I came up with this idea to put everything into one tool, have a whole toolbox in one. And I call this the total tool. And it really is a whole toolbox in one. I'm going to walk you through it here and show you the things that it does. It's a hammer, and it's a pair of pliers, slip joint, or they're called channel locks or water pump pliers. It's also a crescent wrench, it's a wire cutter, and lots more things. I'll show you how they work. You can take this apart, and you have just the crescent wrench by itself, if you want to use it that way. And if you slip this off, you have the hammer, so you can use it just as a little hammer. Now this is a spark plug socket. It's a 13/16 on one end and a 5/8 on the other, so it's both sizes of spark plug sockets. And this tool, on the back of this, you can unscrew this little fitting, and inside of here you have a knife blade, and you have a can opener, a bottle opener, and also, this is a prototype, but the production model would also have a hacksaw and a little file built in the side of it. Now on this end of the handle you have a stubby screwdriver, and the tips for it are stored inside. There's a variety of them here. There's room for more tips, but you'd select the tip you want to use, and you just you snap it in here, and then you have a little stubby screwdriver that you can use. If you want to have a full-size screwdriver, then you just snap it in here, and you have a full-size screwdriver you can use. Now, let's say you got a really tight screw, and you can't break it loose just with your hand like that. You reach inside of this, unscrew this cap, and here is a complete socket set with extension bar and breaker bar. And the sockets, I'll get to those in just a second. The breaker bar you can use to manipulate this. If you've got a real tight screw, you can crack it loose like so. Or, of course, if you've got a spark plug down in a hole, you stick this in here, and you can use it to unscrew the spark plug. Now, the breaker bar in the production model would have also a inches scale down this side, and on this side a metric scale. So this could be used as a little ruler and also as a hole depth gauge to measure the depth of a hole. The sockets are very unique. Each one is computer designed so that it will fit a metric or an SAE type fastener. But they're also unique because they're double ended. So each socket represents four socket sizes. So you actually have 20 different sizes of sockets right there. Now go back to the screwdriver for a minute. If you use the breaker bar, you can snap it in like this, and if you want to have crack loose a really tight screw that's in a tight area, you can use it that way. You can also use the screwdriver as an extension, and so if you need to reach further than just the short extension will allow you, then you can do it that way. Also, the handle of the breaker bar itself can be used as an extension because it has a receiver ball, and you can snap a socket on the end and reach down in a hole and get to a fastener that's down like so. So it's a really versatile tool. It does a lot of things. It's strong. I've used it in field testing over the last year to do a variety of jobs. I've managed to, let's see, for example, I put a new alternator on an Acura. I put a water pump on a Mazda. I did a tune-up on a Toyota. I bought some new furniture at the assembly warehouse and brought the furniture home, assembled it all with this tool. I took my friend's toaster apart and put a new cord on his toaster. And just every job that I've tried to get it to do, it does. It's strong, and it works really well. It has a wire cutter I mentioned to you. I'm going to show you how that works just in a second here. If you reattach the pliers and slide them to their fullest open position, there's a wire cutter right here, so you can snip wires and also strip them with that. And I just want to thank you for considering my tool. I think it's a very unique invention. One thing I'd like to mention about it, I think its market is really good for motorcycles. It's a really good sized tool to be able to fit in tight places. And also, it's good for campers. Put one in your glove box of your car. And housewives, maybe keep one in the junk drawer of the kitchen. There's just really a lot of uses for it. And I'm proud of it. So anyway, thanks for looking at it and considering it. I'd like to draw your attention to the various parts here. This is the stubby screwdriver, which has a hex orifice on this end and a four-sided orifice on this end, so that it can be driven with the breaker bar on this end and accept the six-sided tips in this end. These are just some various tips. There's many others that are available. And actually, if this tool were going to be marketed to Harley-Davidson, for example, there's a variety of tips that would work specifically for a Harley that could be put into the tool. This is the knife blade with the can opener, bottle opener, and then of course the file and hacksaw would be in addition. This is the spark plug socket, 13/16 on this end and 5/8 on this end. This is the hammer head, the slip joint pliers. This is the wire cutter. This is the cutting side, and the anvil side is on the underside of the crescent wrench. This is the receiver tube for the tips. There's a division inside of it so that the screwdriver tips are stored in this end and the knife blade is stored in this end. This is the hollow handle for the stock socket storage, the breaker bar, and then the sockets, as I explained, are each one shaped slightly different so that they will fit on metric or SAE sockets. And of course, this is just a 1-inch long, 1/4-inch extension.